Hey guys, welcome to another day on the shop. Today, we're still working on the 240. A couple more parts we gotta get in order, so it's taking a little bit longer than I wanted because I should have already had the parts, but seeing as I don't have a turbo inlet coupler and a cold or hot side coupler, I need one because they're step downs or step ups, the way however you want to look at it. One's a 90 at 2 inches and these step up to a 2.5. The other is a 2.25 and needs to step up to a 2.5. So yeah, it's a 2.5 to a 3, and I don't have anything smaller than that that I can actually use. The only thing I do have is a bunch of straights of 2 inch, and that's not going to do what I need it to do, because I need to come around this corner right here and come out and come back this way. So I need it to go up and out, or I need it to come straight out. So that is a problem, and a couple other little small issues that I have pertaining to exhaust. I gotta lengthen my exhaust, so I have to order some pipe for that. But the fun thing is y'all don't have to look at a whole another video of just one little fabrication deal. I get to play with this ESAB EMP 210, so happy about that. It's a full out TIG MIG stick setup, so I get to play and learn some skills. What's left on this turbo kit is we got the oil drain, which that's not it, it's in there, it looks exactly the same. We got a fuel pump, we got gauges, we've got an intercooler, and then a whole bunch of piping. Oh, and the fuel injectors and the computer. So we got a few things. So today I want to go ahead and I guess route my gauges. I'm gonna route my gauges and start looking at getting to the fuel system, because the fuel pump just needs to be slapped in there. It already is low on fuel, so since it's low, it makes a perfect time to throw in a fuel pump. There's one other thing. My water to the turbo, I figured it out. You can't see in here. I have a looped coolant line that is on the back here. You can't really see, but it loops the coolant line because I don't have a heater core anymore, which one day I'll get one. It's just a pain in the butt, and I don't feel like paying a whole bunch of money for metal ends instead of plastic ends, because plastic ones break. So with the loop end is I'm just going to loop it through the turbo instead of it just looping right at the back of the engine. And that will produce the water I need for cooling the turbo, as well as cooling down the oil inside the turbo. So we've figured those two things out. Good thing, but I've got to get more coolant line, and I've got to get an adapter for the coolant line to go from point A to point B. The other thing I got to do is I got to get a bigger hammer. My downpipe down there, exhaust, is still potentially hitting the body. So we're going to take care of that. And we've got motor mounts we got to put in. But before we can finish off on the downpipe, we had to get our motor mounts in because I think it raises the motor a little bit from where it's at right now. So if that's the case, then the issue we're going to run into is I'm going to have to beat the body even further in so the downpipe fits. So let's get to it. Okay, so the two gauges I'm installing, one is a boost gauge with a vacuum, it is a cheap gauge, and the other is an AEM fuel air fuel ratio gauge. I've had this air fuel ratio gauge for a long time. I found out they burn up in the back, and you have to either solder them back or buy a new one. So with that, we're going to pop these two gauges in, we're going to wire them in, and I've got to find out where I want my air fuel ratio sensor somewhere down there, because the test pipe that I have comes off the side of it, but I think it's coming off too far. I do have some more bungs for said stuff. There's one. So when I lengthen the exhaust, I can put another bung in there for the air fuel ratio gauge. If not, I might can fit it in there, I'm not sure. But we're gonna have everything ran to a gauge pillar pod up here, which I don't really care for, but that's what I got. And I'm trying to be extra cheap with this, to the fact of just doing what is necessary, but minimum money. So, gauge pod right here, and that's what's gonna go in there. Need to clean a little bit, probably sprayed with some paint, but let's get to it. All right, well, found another thing I gotta order. This apparently is, I bought this when I had a S14, so this does not really fit. The contours of it don't fit the actual panel for the A-pillar. So, cheap, easy fix. I still can go ahead and wire in my stuff, so it's sitting there waiting on the new gauge pod to come in, because all it is you drill a hole in the existing A-pillar trim piece and route your wires through there. So basically I can route my wires, just not drill my hole yet until I get my gauge pod in, but they'll be sitting there ready to go. So let's do that and at least get that started. Alright, so we found a spot where the hood release is. Let's see if I can get you some light down there. Alright, so that's where I'm probably going to go with my wire. And then I'll probably just route it up top through all this, over the booster, and back down next to the transmission. This kind of thick wire, I'm hoping it'll fit right through there. And it should. I'm just going to not do the cleanest little doohickey. I'm just going to pull this apart and shove it in there. Alright, so quick look. I got that in there. I just got to close off that grommet because I had to cut it and pull it out. Fish the wire all the way through. I had to use a welding wire to get it through the dash right here, but it goes through and goes down there so that I don't have to drill any holes, and it's clean. This is the only thing that's not going to look 100% clean. But this grommet down here is going to go over that anyway, so I shouldn't have an issue with that. My next thing is I can wire the wideband in and not have it hooked up. My problem is my boost gauge has to be wired in and installed at the same time. I could put little connectors on here, which possibly might do, and just so I don't have to deal with all the wires like this, I'll cut them short and wire them up, and so all I gotta do is plug them all in together. I'll heat shrink them together so that they come in one little strand through there, just like that other one, because I still have another hole set up I've got to get in through the dash right here, just down through the dash into the compartment down there with the fuse box. So I've got two of those. And if I can pre-wire this one for the boost gauge, it'll make it simpler to install. And I won't have all this right here. My only issue is I'll have connectors on the back side of them, which they won't be pretty, and they're not small. They're actually kind of large. So, in turn, yeah. It is what it is, so I'm going to have to make that work. So let's get to wiring, or cutting the wires on this and combining it going down into the dash. After doing some research, I changed my mind of where I want to place my O2 sensor. This one's all beat up. I need a new one, but it works, so I'm not too worried about it. It does the job. So this one's gonna go in the test pipe. I'm gonna run another wire to it. And then my wideband's gonna go into the turbo elbow right there. So with that, makes it a little bit easier. And plus, I still have some of this heat wrap that I'm gonna be using in a couple places so that I don't catch it on fire. I'll be using this on the water lines as well, just because it's so close to the header. So we don't get boiling water or melted hoses, even though it is heater hose and it is thick. So, as well as I've changed my mind. I've looked at my gauge pod for up here, and see, I've already ran this, as y'all saw, to a gauge pod down here. It's cheaper, I like it better. It's not all race car looking, kind of a little bit more subtle. So I like that better, and that's probably where I'm going to go with it. So I've already lengthened these wires a little bit. I cut them off the gauge. Here's the boost gauge. I cut them and put some so I don't have to have, I can run the wires and I don't have to have the gauge hooked into it while I'm running them through the gauge pod. So this makes it a little bit easier for that too. So now I just got to run these to where I need them and then put them on the column. And I got to do the same for the wideband. So that's one of my next things. Still got some heat shrink on here, just kind of holding this stuff together. Need to finish that. And then we're going to pull this bumper off. That's what I want to do next, pull this bumper off. So let's get to it. Okay, so wired everything up. Well, sort of. I routed all the wires up to the column, and how I'm going to do it, I have to wait because I have to get the mount and drill a hole in the top of it. And then I've got to rewire, or I've got to plug in the wideband and the boost gauge to all the wiring that it goes to. This is the other part of the wideband. I just got to curl it up because it's kind of long and leave me enough to where I can finagle it up here. So that's the next part to cleaning up all this wire. And once I do that, it should be ready to install. So I love having change of plans in the middle of the build. So yeah, I'm gonna see if I can wire all this in and knock this out real quick so that I can move on to the bumper and other things. So let's get to it. All right, moment of truth. I've just hooked up my gauges, so got the wires all done. Let's see if I can move y'all closer. All right, there y'all go. All right, I'm gonna click the key on. All right, so it's reading zero on that. That's loading. 14.9, 15. So that's hooked in. So might go a little haywire because it's hooked up, but nothing. All right. And then a hose for the boost gauge. Vacuum. Pressure. And then lights. No lights. Alright. So, got all that done. It's pretty awesome. So, gauges are to a point in. Now, I gotta put my radio back together. That's where I hooked it all in, all ghetto style. Oh, so I can pull it apart anytime I need to. So, that is done. Next is pulling this front bumper off. Clean up my wires mess on the floor right there. So, radio back in. We're gonna pull this front bumper real quick. Alright, so there are four bolts up front. You gotta take these headlight or these lights out and unclip them. If you do like I do and zip tie everything, you might have some zip ties. There's about three, I think, bolts on each side up in the fender well. So that's what I'm doing next. And This thing should just fall off, hopefully. Let's go. All right, so there's technically supposed to be, I guess, five. One, two, three, four, five. I had four, and then I had no bolts holding the bottom up on the fender. It was just zip ties. So four on each side, and then I had two right here holding it to that part on the support right here. And I guess, yeah. So I don't have anything holding it up to the bumper. I guess screws right there, and I could get them, and I might put two in there next time just to hold it a little bit better. But now I've got to move some stuff around, because that intercooler needs to go right about here, and I don't know if it's going to clear everything the way it is. So quick test fit, we're just going to stick it in here and see how far up it is. And if it's too far up, we don't have a condenser in, which I want to put back later, so I don't want to chop anything up too much. So let's see if it'll fit right here with no fabrication or cutting. So hold on. Well, it's too difficult to show you, but this fits pretty much perfect in here. It does take up half of the intercooler right there. So I could either cut half of this out, and like most people do, and just have the bottom exposed. And I mean, I could weld a plate up here and just call it a day just for reinforcement, but yeah, this fits pretty good right behind here with no modifications whatsoever. But like I said, I'd still have to cut part of this out, and I still may just lop it off right about where the support is for the lights. Come across right there from side to side, do that. And then on the bumper, looks like all I had to do is just clearance right here and maybe right there, which then I still have the issue that this comes across right here, and so that means I'd have still about that much intercooler sticking up. The other route is kind of cut this further down and hang the intercooler further down. And that gave me some more air. Not trying to push the limits of this thing, so I think it'll be okay. Even if I just hang it down just a little bit. But we'll have to see. So, yeah. More interesting stuff tomorrow. Alright, so we tore off the front bumper. I began test fitting this. I like where it is, but these little brackets that I've had for years on here don't fit. So I had a piece of a ladder, and now I'm going to use the pieces of the ladder for an aluminum brace. So I'm going to come off where the bolt is here, come up, and it's going to be a little bit twist of an angle, and I'm going to nip this right here and straighten that out. But they're gonna bolt right there. So, it'll be a solid mount. It'll be good. It'll be right up front. It won't be any sort of clearance issues with that. I've already cut, this isn't the greatest job, but I've already cut the plastic right there. The intercooler's gonna sit right here against it. I'm gonna pull this up so it will give better airflow as well. So, as it's sitting down there, y'all can see it good. There you go. So it's got a lot of airflow coming from that direction. So that's what I'm doing right now. So yep, I'm gonna drill these little rivets out right here gonna drill these holes bigger right there, and then we're gonna put this on here, cut it, drill the other holes, and come at an angle and twist it to fit right there. So that's what I'm doing. Let's get to it. Alright, looking good. Sturdy, it's holding it away from the bumper support. Brings it up just a little bit and retains everything where it needs to retain. So, we need to make one more over here, and do the same thing and support this to where it doesn't move. So, let's do that. All right, there's a decent amount of airflow. The intercooler doesn't hit the back of the bumper or the bumper support, so, and it doesn't hit the bumper itself. It might, yeah, I don't even know. I might even want to cut it down a little bit because I can get a little bit more airflow if I cut it down just a hair more down there. Either that, or possibly put a zip tie or something to pull them down. If I did that, it would, yep, it would give about an inch more of airflow. But seeing I'm running about 8 PSI, it shouldn't hurt. So it's centered, looks good. I just gotta figure out this bumper real quick, and if I can figure out the bumper, then we're in business and I can move on to the next thing. All right, put a couple zip ties. It doesn't seem to be hitting the intercooler. It might, I don't know. Plastic piece on the bottom is resting on the bottom of it. Creates some better aerodynamics, but then I gotta bolt this top part up. But that gave me an extra row because this lip came up to that one, that air hole, and now it's further down, so that looks better. All right, so intercooler's in, bumper's trimmed, bumper's good. Now I've got to start looking at piping coming from right there, up in here, through here, over, because got to go over into here. Got me some elbows. Got me an elbow. I got to trim it down a little bit, but I can kind of lean it like that or whatever. But I'm gonna have a 90 coming out. I don't know how I'm gonna do this. Something similar to that. So I don't have stuff to TIG aluminum or MIG it or anything. So I've got to use couplers. I got pipe. I've got couplers. The good thing is I got some 90 degrees, so I got one blue, couple black, or a couple blue, mostly blue, and then I got black. So we're gonna see how this goes. I don't plan on it being the greatest, but it's getting there slowly. I've got to still pull the exhaust back out, raise the engine just to throw in my motor mounts. And once I do that, I don't know if it's going to sit a little bit taller or not. It may. It'll ride smoother though, and the vibration of the engine won't kill me. Let's see what else. Like I said, we got the gauges in, air cooler's in, downpipe is kind of where I want it. The wiring was the biggest part. That was a pain in the butt. Let's see. Wiring and routing of all the stuff. The only thing I got left on the hoses is I got to put that grommet back, and that's a pain in the butt. Also, since my clutch line has never given me a full out good clutch feel, because that thing, that's how it was. I always thought it was leaking air. Went ahead and ordered some parts from Injuku. Got a new clutch line. It's stainless, it plugs right in. With a banjo bolt, goes from that side down there, down to the transmission, plugs into the slave cylinder. That's what I need. So yeah, intercooler. Finito, done. Now need to remove this and then start looking at how I'm routing this pipe down here. This janky thing, I don't know what I'm gonna do with it. I don't even know if it really does anything good. Yeah, I gotta figure some stuff out. So 8 psi, the 370 injectors should be pushing around 180 wheel, praying for 200 maybe, because it's a T3, it's a little bit bigger than a T25. So we will see. My oil, I have a T down there already, but it's just a T, and it's way down there. I'm probably going to put this quad fitting down there, because all I'm doing is adding one line, and I'll get rid of that T, which can eliminate some problems, because it's a brass fitting that doesn't match up to the thread pattern in the block and everything else. So I kind of just made it janky and got it in there. This has all the correct spec stuff, and my stainless line. Gonna route around back, the back of the engine, and come out side here, plug into the top part here. I gotta get another line for a drain. I do have my drain for the actual turbo. Been ordering parts. They're taking a lot while to come in. I've got it. My gauge pod is a couple weeks out, so. But we're going to continue working throughout all this to make this work, because we're going to get this thing done. It was supposed to be done a while back. Oh, come on. Show you the difference between a T4 outlet and a T28. All right, first, the size difference. All right, next, the bolt holes. They don't line up. This is bigger. So, both aluminum. Not the greatest, but they'll do. I like the lip on this one a little bit better than this one. And it almost stands taller. So, that's my turbo drain. Still gotta get a hose for that. Gotta get some heater hose and some adapters. And once I do that, I should have everything I need to get this thing all the way finished. Yeah, minus just making sure I have everything. I got to order a set of plug wires, because that one plug wire from the beginning tore the boot off. Let me find it. Yeah, it tore the little end boot off and it destroyed itself. So that could have been my issue from it stumbling and everything else. Yeah, we're getting done slowly. But if you stay tuned for this, get some burnouts and turbo noises. Then we're gonna kind of go from this roll and swap back to the Camaro, because I got some plans. I'm ready for it to be up. I've got almost everything I need for it. Got to order a few things. Once I order those few things, I'll be ready to go. So, say one or two more videos of work. And then once I get that work done, then it comes down to testing out, making sure everything is good, making sure I'm not overheating, catching on fire, or anything else. So thank you for joining in to another day of the shop, another episode. Check out some Teespring, get you some merch, check out Instagram, check out Facebook, check out TikTok. Got a lot of TikToks coming up. And videos, promotions, anything. Got giveaways. But anyway, thanks for joining in for another episode, and until next time.